WAAF Real Rock TV is brought to you in part by Kahlua.
Hey, what's going on? It's Carrie, and we're on Real Rock TV. It's the Fishing Musician. We're out here in the middle of the Atlantic on a nice Friday afternoon. Rocco's at work. Where am I? I'm fishing. The guy's from Clutch. Check it out. I think he's catching one right now. You think you got one?
I think I got a little one. Not much fight in it.
Not much fight to kill it, all right.
Not like the great white I caught earlier.
It had a gold bullion inside, too. Not only was it a fish, but it had treasure inside. All right, we got Clutch and Slayer live down at Avalon. We also got Feeder on this episode of Real Rock TV, so stay tuned for more.
That's just as well, because I think he left.
Thank you. guy didn't help. You're playing the wrong chords, man.
WAAF, Real Rock TV. It's all about the music.
Maybe hell. Maybe we could play.
Could be Mike's fault.
Some Dawkins tunes, then you get those right.
WAAF, Real Rock TV.
So we're talking about Slayer. Clutch's new CD just came out. It's called The Elephant Riders. And to promote the CD, they're on tour with Slayer. How is that?
It's excellent. I think the crowds, they are more accepting of us than I had thought they would be. We do get small change thrown at us, but...
What hurts more, a quarter or a penny when it's getting flipped at you?
There's more sting in a penny.
Really?
A quarter's more of an impact. It's like a blunt force trauma versus a cut.
It's more dense. All right, I see. But the little ridges on the side of the quarter don't give you a friction burn as they're whizzing by?
I suppose it could, but I've been lucky to escape that.
Cool.
Natural force field around me.
Exactly. I see that. Very cool.
This is Stain of Mind.
Thank you.
said, son, you're going to drive and drink and
make mistakes! Make mistakes!
How do you feel after bringing in a big catch like that?
I feel like a dick.
He feels like a dick. It's so cute, isn't it? Bye-bye.
Relax. It's Pat. WAAF's Real Rock TV.
How's it going? It's Carrie.
Hi, I'm Neil.
All right, we're fishing with the guys from Clutch out here in the Atlantic Ocean, freezing our asses off, getting soaked, but I caught a fish. Did you catch a fish?
I caught two fish.
Well, two fish, one fish. We caught some. So you've been traveling, you're doing a whole United States tour. Where are some of the cool places that you've been so far?
I really liked Arizona, and this has actually been a really quick tour for us. We just hit some places really quick. Toronto, which was last night, is a great town to play. I really like Toronto. And tomorrow in Philly. Excuse me. And
a little burp there, that's all right.
And I like Kansas as well. Kansas was good, too.
I think I would rather be in Arizona right now where it's hot and balmy. We've been playing a different song off the CD every night as part of our eargasm, and we're getting positive feedback on a lot of the stuff. What about the instrumental that's on there, track number 9, the Cracker Jack? Is that more of a band jam with you guys, or is that something that you really planned out? Because it sounds great.
Well, it was something that was very spur of the moment, and actually the take that's on the album was the second time that song had ever been played. And it's the trombone player is Delphio Marsalis, from the Marsalis family's younger brother, Branford Marsalis. And he came down one day, we invited him down, and we played him a track, and, you know, in a matter of hours, he had the, you know, whole thing scoped out. And that was the second take, and it was just something we wanted to give the album more breathing room, and we thought an instrumental would be good for that.
Where do you get the inspiration for some of these songs, like the Yeti and even the Elephant Riders? Your lyrics are a lot more intelligent and the songs are more deep than, I'm giving you a compliment here, but the music's a lot more deep than some of the other stuff that is coming out right now. Where do you draw for inspiration for the songs on the CD?
Well, I try to tell a story, and if I can just get one good line that just catches my ear, I can kind of exaggerate that or elaborate on it. And a lot of it I get out of things I read or I just see on TV, but most of it is just pure imagination. So there's a good element of fantasy to the lyrics.
What did you get for inspiration for the title track, The Elephant Riders? That song, we're getting a lot of positive feedback from the listeners, and I just wanted to know what kind of spiked your brain as far as getting the inspiration for that song.
At one point in time, I had heard that a Civil War officer used camels as pack animals out west, and that got me to thinking about different animals, zebras, giraffes, rhinoceroses, but I settled on elephants, and that's really the only surreal element of that song. The rest is sort of a catalog of the area that we used to live in.
It's very cool.
Clearly, I'm a victim now. wait a little bit, the doctor is why, oh why?
He's dead.
Well, look, there's a seagull right there. I'm just,
It's the food chain in action right here. We got the dead fish, we got the seagull.
The two will meet.
I feel like a
dick. Look, they're going in.
Oh, here we go, look, look.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
WAAF Real Rock TV is brought to you in part by Kahlua.
Hey, what's going on, you maniacs? It's Rocco, WAAF's Real Rock TV, down here on Cape Cod. It's my house here on the Cape. Got to clean up the pool. Summer's coming. People want to come over and party. It's Real Rock TV. On this episode, we're going to see Clutch, Limp Bizkit, and Stabbing Westward. In the meantime, you watch. I'm cleaning. Look at this stuff. You know, where's the help when you need it, man? Real Rock TV, baby.
I'm Neil.
Hi, I'm Dan. I play bass.
I'm Tim. I play guitar.
We're on Columbia Records now.
which hopefully will do a much better job than Atlantic did. Which can't be hard.
And that's been said out loud many times.
Yeah.
What's up with, how was the record label so important to a band's success?
Well, distribution, getting records in stores, believe it or not, is sometimes difficult for major labels. And tour support. You know, basic things. I mean, we basically promoted ourselves for the past, you know, 3 years by doing road shows.
Right.
And now hopefully we'll have support, you know, in advertisements and, you know, the basics.
Limp Bizkit invited us on the tour.
Wow. So yes. The Limp Bizkit fans of you guys?
That's what I heard. I haven't had a chance to really meet them yet. Today's the first day of the tour.
What can you say about fans of Clutch's music? Is there a generalization that you can make?
Psychotic.
Anonymous white males.
We've toured with a lot of different bands, and in the process we've picked up a lot of different types of fans, I guess you could say. So there's really a mix when we play, and it's cool because it keeps it interesting. Well, that what you read is just going to be part of a CD extra, a CD-ROM that's on the album. And I just thought it would be kind of a cool way to make the basis of the CD-ROM. I didn't want to get too involved so it would get boring, but I just wanted to kind of explain the highlights. Because sometimes, you know, I've read on the internet where kids kind of like to enjoy to decipher the songs and completely maul them. And I just want to set the record straight. Usually it starts just with some mumbling words, you know. If there's a riff, and I'll come up with a rhythm and a melody first, and I'll fill in the words, and I'll let the rhyme scheme, you know, work, and you know, because that just was more interesting rather than having a goal from the beginning. That's how it works for me.
Now, whether it's like samurais or Civil War veterans, what's up with creating a place and time with the music? I mean, it seems to be very, very distinct in your lyrics and in your presentation.
I would say it's more of a fantasy type thing, rather than it's entertainment basically, and I enjoy rather doing those things than singing about childhood traumas or, you know, my diary entries, just because it's funnier.
Roll on, roll on. Run away to Washington.